Great pleasure. Okay. Welcome, everybody. It's a great pleasure for me to welcome you here. Even though the Budinich Hall is empty, I'm sure all of you are connected from all over the world. And there are a few people present in the Budinich Hall. So it's a wonderful occasion for ICTP to celebrate 30 years of ICTP Postgraduate Diploma Programme. And we have an exciting program for the next 3 days. There are more than 400 registered participants. And we are quite excited about the fact that we are able to reconnect. So before we start, I would like to just welcome you with the ICTP welcome video. So please go ahead.
Humans have always been curious. Why is the world the way it is? How does the world work? What does the future hold? The excitement of new ideas, passionate pursuit of new knowledge, expanding the horizons of all. These belong to everyone. The Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics has a unique mission that supports research excellence in physics and mathematics, and the nurturing of sustainable science for all. ICTP's founder, the Nobel Laureate Abdus Salam, believed that science is the common heritage of all humanity. The center supports researchers from less advantaged countries and works to remove barriers they may face. Here, everyone speaks one common language, science. Basic and applied research are both vital for society, from fundamental particles to black holes, from climate change to quantum computing. Work at collaboration opens doors. The exchanges and global scientific networks built here create fertile ground for new discoveries. These connections encourage brain gain. ICTP's training and education programs support scientists throughout their careers. They share their knowledge with students, enriching the global community of researchers. ICTP, where outstanding scientists explore the frontiers of knowledge, build capacity, and promote bright minds. A community united by the power of science.
Okay, so let's continue with the program. Let me just say a few words of introduction. The purpose of this event is in fact twofold. One is of course to celebrate this wonderful occasion of 30 years of anniversary of the Postgraduate Diploma Program, which has been an essential component of ICTP's global mission. And we would like to also take this opportunity to help establish more firmly the ICTP global community through regional networks to strengthen our presence everywhere, taking input from all of you so that we can better serve scientists and students coming from the developing world. Because we at ICTP believe that great science knows no borders, and scientific talent is found everywhere. And you all, I mean, Ramanujan, the great Indian mathematician, was an inspiring example of this. And all of you are a testimony to the success and the correctness of this belief, fundamental belief of ICTP. So we are very proud of you. ICTP is very proud of you, because many of you have gone on to do wonderful things in science. Some of you have left science but have made a mark in other fields. And we are here to really learn from each other's experience, what the alumni have done. And in fact, we are joined not only by the students, but also our associates and other alumni, other members of the ICTP global community will be joining in. Also the members of the scientific council, the steering committee. So I'm really looking forward to a very interesting and exciting program. I should emphasize that the need for this sort of came from the bottom up, to move towards a more organized ICTP global community. And I should give special thanks to Nushkia Chamba. She was the student, one of the former students, but she was spearheading this effort. And my colleague here, Professor Paolo Creminelli, whom, as you know, is a cosmologist, but also the head of the high energy physics section. So, and the team that worked together for making this event possible, even though our idea was to maybe we can hold it in person, but hopefully next year we can have an ICTP reunion in person on the Trieste campus. And I hope all of you can make it at that time. So let me now quickly move over to a short presentation about ICTP. Of course, you know ICTP very well, and I don't need to tell you about ICTP, but it's good to remind ourselves about what we stand for and what are the goals and where we would like to go from here. So this is the our celebration. As you know, this ICTP was founded in 1964 by the great physicist from Pakistan, Abdus Salam, to enhance international cooperation through science. And it is governed by tripartite agreement between the Italian government, UNESCO, and IAEA. And as you can see here on this blackboard, students from all over come together to discuss science. And the ICTP Postgraduate Diploma Programme, I mean, every year, this is one of the years when we had this graduation ceremony, and I wish we were able to hold this program in person. It's a wonderful experience. Every time I attend this, I always feel sort of reinvigorated about the mission of ICTP, because it's a wonderful rainbow of people from all over the world, young scientists preparing for their future career. More than 1,000 diploma students have graduated from 85 countries, and 75% have gone on to do or are working towards their PhDs, and about a third of them are female. So I think we are beginning to do better in terms of gender balance. About 42% are from Africa, another 42% from Asia, and the remaining are from Latin America, 15%, and a small fraction from Europe. We have some very prominent alumni, some of them, of course, many, not all of them are included here, but these are the people who will be part of the roundtable discussion tomorrow, and you will see them there in person. Freddy Cacciazzo, who is now a Dyson Chair in Theoretical Physics, Ryan Abele-Reyes, Ntoya Paul-Rapapa, Mabuba Diagne, and Rondrotiana Barimalala. As you can see, they are now have done, some of them are Minister Rapapa, he's a minister in Lesotho. Professor Reyes, he's a professor. Freddy Cacciazzo is a professor at Perimeter. Diagne is a vice president in ECOWAS Bank. And Bari Malala is with the Department of Oceanography. So you can see that there are diverse careers and people have done ICTP's ICTP's program has had really a big impact around the world. Now, of course, about 70% of our students enroll in PhD programs. In fact, some of them actually are absorbed in the Trieste science system itself at ICTP at CISA, the University of Trieste. And there are various PhDs that we offer, and now also masters in high performance computing, in complex system, in medical physics, apart from the PhDs in physics, mathematics, earth systems, and fluid dynamics. Now, as you know, the mission of ICTP has two foundational pillars. One is, of course, to build capacity in advanced science and to bridge the gap, knowledge divide, and to promote international cooperation to make science available to everyone. But this equally important is to conduct world-class research at the frontiers of science, and they both sort of help each other. And this dual mandate is what makes ICTP unique. I think there are not many, perhaps not any other universities in the world which do the same in the same, with the same level of impact. And many of you have graduated from here, so you know that we have five major sections. which you're all familiar with. The quantitative license is the new entrant to this to the existing five, and they also have started a new diploma program starting recently. And the applied physics program now has been reorganized as a science, technology, and innovation unit. And as I said, intellectual excellence is fundamental to ICTP and to all of you, because you want to go where the best science is done. And as you know, ICTP has claims to the five, has contributed directly or indirectly to four Nobel Peace Prize, Physics Prizes, and one Nobel Peace Prize. Sorry. It's stuck, it's not moving. Can you move the slide, please? Okay. Okay. So now, one of the important aspects of ICTP's approach is that our engagement with all of you, and this is why we are here, and I really want you to, I'm looking forward to new ideas from all of you, and to be able to help us do our mission in a better way, deliver our own mission better way, that ICTP engages with scientists throughout their career. It's not that we just, you do your diploma program and then you're done. As you can see, many of you, there are several examples. For example, Narayan Adhikari is an example. Perhaps he's an audience who is now a professor in Nepal, but who started as a graduate student, as a postgraduate student, and has been an associate. So we keep our engagement throughout the career of a scientist, either at the, as when they enter as students, at their PhD time, through conferences when they visit us here, and also as associates, and then as senior members who send us back new students and who create new regional cells of ICTP. So that's really the kind of multiplier effect that ICTP is seeking, that one person actually corresponds to hundreds of new students, and this is what we have seen in many countries. So, and this multiplier effect is really the strength of ICTP, and that's, this is what one of the purposes, I think I would like at the end of this 3-day meeting, we come up with new ideas to figure out how to make this multiplier effect work even better, so that we can expand our mission more widely and more deeply. Again, next. Okay. And as part of this lifelong engagement, as you know, we hold something like 60 conferences. So many of you, even after they go back to their home countries or go somewhere else, they keep coming back to ICTP, because we have something like 60 really high class conferences organized at ICTP, something like 5,000 scientists visit from 145 nations. And in addition, we have hosted activities. So something like 1,000 to 2,000 scientists come in hosted activities. And many of the scientists actually come for long-term visits as associates. So I became the director 2 years ago, and the new strategic plan for ICTP was approved last year for the next 5 years. And one of the points that I would like to really emphasize is to how to enhance this, how to really benefit from ICTP's global community. And this is where I need input from all of you. And so I please put your thinking hats and come back with some good ideas. This need for this global community. I gave the example of Nushkia, but now you will later on hear about our colleagues from Pakistan, where they put together the Pakistan ICTP Alumni Association. So this is again an effort to make our community stronger and more connected with each other. And especially in the times of COVID has made us realize that maybe there are new ways of engaging, even when you're not coming here in person. Maybe we can think of new platforms, new technology, in addition to, of course, personalized visits are very, very important for science. We really need to discuss physics or discuss science in person, but perhaps we can find ways to multiply this better using new technology. So this is something that I would like you to think about, So as you can see at the top of the pyramid, we have a small number of permanent scientists, but by the time you get down to number of students, number of visitors, online training, and internet, it really has a huge impact. And there are a number of initiatives that are part of the strategic plan is to develop a kind of an international consortium for scientific computing. And this is really important because I think 10 years from now, data science, machine learning, all these things are going to be pervasive in all areas of science. And you know, we cannot leave it only to Google and Facebook to take the lead. Training scientists for this purpose is going to be essential. As I said, we started a new diploma. Quantum computation, quantum simulation, all this can be part of this consortium. We have started a diploma in quantitative life sciences, in sort of dealing with these related areas. We are expanding our medical physics. But broadly, we really want to think of an ICTP global community, both physically and online. And perhaps through membership pages for all of you so that you can connect to ICTP more easily. Some other ideas, maybe through local initiatives like the regional centers or alumni associations. So I think this is an opportunity for all of us to, and ICTP would support this, any experimentation that you would like to do in this direction, so that we can strengthen our network and make it more broadly available. So I think I'm pretty close to, can you, next slide, please? Yeah, okay, I'm close to my presentation. I would now give the floor to Professor Saif Ranjbar Daimi, who, as you know, I'm sure those of you who were here before know him as he was the former deputy director of ICTP. But more importantly, he was also the co-founder of this program. And I have seen him and many of my colleagues in the high energy section, like Josh Thompson, Narayan, really giving everything, really spending enormous amount of time to really develop the curriculum, to think about the best ways to get the best students to reach out to all corners of the world. So it is thanks to the efforts of these wonderful colleagues that I have that we are able to do this. And so I would give this floor now to Saif to say a few words about the history of this diploma program. Thanks, Saif. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Atish. Thank you very much. And I would also like to thank Paolo for inviting me to participate in this nice meeting. Let me see how, okay. This is indeed a very pleasant occasion for me to not only to witness the program after 30 years and so much success, but also see some of the faces of various years of the face of the students of various years of this program. So the idea, of course, goes back to Abdus Salam, like every other idea in those days in ICTP. Although the final format that the program took was different from the way that he had thought about. In fact, Salam was a very resourceful person in terms of ideas. Almost every day he came, not only with a pile of preprints under his arm, and he found all of them interesting, but also with a large number of ideas of how ICTP should develop in various directions. He shared the belief that the human curiosity was the main driving force in science, and the young girls and boys in developing countries were not less curious or less talented than those in economically and industrially advanced countries. He was unique among scientists of his own rank in the sense that he dedicated a big part of his time. And I must add that time is the most valuable capital that the scientist has. But he dedicated a big part of his time to help scientists from less privileged parts of the world And the ICTP Diploma Programme is one of many concrete steps of ICTP services to developing countries. Its concreteness is, in fact, witnessed by the presence of the alumni in this meeting, as well as by the numbers that Professor Dabulkar presented about the number of graduates from diploma program, and more importantly, the number of PhDs. Over 500-600 people have obtained their PhDs going through the diploma program of ICTP. Now, the program took some time to be actually created. Many discussions went during 1990s, and eventually the diploma program was modeled on a one-year diploma program at the Imperial College of London. And the format was essentially retained, at least at the higher education section, until this year. I understand that this year some modifications are going to be implemented. Initially, we took students only in high energy and condensed matter physics. And this is perhaps the first group photo of the students of condensed matter and high energy physics. Now, probably some of you or some of the students of the people present in this picture will actually recognize their teachers. And of course, if you are participating, you will also recognize yourself. I would like to single out here Ms. Concetta Mosca. She was one of the three female presence in this picture. She is the one standing next to me, if you can recognize me still. And she played an important role.
So if you need to share your transparencies.
Sorry?
Just a minute. I think your slides have to be shared.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You need to share the screen, I think.
Yes, I'm trying to do it. I forgot to do it. And I think I should go there. Sorry for that. Okay, is it visible now? Hello?
Yes, Safa, go ahead.
Okay, so this is, as I was saying, this is the students from the first year, probably the oldest picture in which the first year students are all present together. I was talking about Ms. Concetta Mosca and her contributions about. 1 year later, mathematics was also included. This is a photo of the students of the three sections together, and together with some of the people involved in running the program, including Professor Salam himself, who was, of course, not involved in running the program. And two people sitting is in his left and right. The one sitting to his left is Professor Lundquist. He was a condensed matter physicist from Sweden. I will say a few words about him a little bit later. And the one on his right is Professor Narasimhan, who passed away, unfortunately, a few months ago. He had just joined to run the mathematics section of ICTP. One thing which is notable in this picture is the number of female students. You see that it is not very much. I think it's, if I counted correctly, there are probably five of them altogether in three sections. But still, for all those days, it was not small, especially considering the fact that they all came from a subset of developing countries. The program was expanded a few years later to include climate physics. This is called Earth System Physics today. And then quantitative life sciences. And as Professor Doublecar mentioned, there will be other additions too. One thing that this program shared with the diploma program at Imperial College was, in fact, the only thing they shared was that it was a one-year program. However, at Imperial College, a very small subset of students were kept to follow their PhD at the college, and then the rest left Imperial College to do their PhDs in other colleges of University of London or other cities in UK or elsewhere. ICTP did not have this opportunity at the beginning, but later on, now, we have many collaborations of this kind with CISA, University of Trieste, and other places. This is a picture which I saw also in the previous presentation of more recent year of a graduation ceremony with many of the colleagues contributing to the program or present here. And one notable aspect of this picture is the increase in the number of female students. We have to take into account that in this celebration ceremony, many of the students actually leave ICTP. They go to the place where they have obtained an admission for PhD or go back to their home country. Nevertheless, this shows this gives an idea of the increase in size. This picture is historical. I have chosen it for one or two reasons. First of all, it's from the second year of the, I think, opening of the high energy diploma program in which Salam is present. Salam, unfortunately, is not present in many of the group pictures of the diploma program. Then I mentioned Lundquist. Next to me is Fahim Hussein, late Fahim Hussein, unfortunately. He played a very important role in setting up the high energy physics diploma program in many respects. He was very close to students, but also it was due to his experience in teaching. I personally was not experienced in teaching to students of this kind, but he had experience in the university teaching. And over the time, he helped us to downsize a little bit the curriculum to a sort of tolerable level. I recently came across with my notes of quantum field theory that I was teaching in those years. And I was amazed of the volume of the topics that we offered to the students. Fahim helped to actually balance it to a size that could be absorbed by students in 1 year. Now it's the sort of, that was an important contribution in my opinion. Lundquist in that meeting said a phrase which I remembered in the course of preparation of this presentation, and to some extent also what Professor Doublecar was saying goes along the same direction. Lundquist said to the students that science is not created by you sitting in your office and contemplating all by yourself. You must go out and interact with other people. This was, if you, probably the students understand the meaning of this sentence, especially the one, they come from various parts of the world with different cultural background, et cetera, and different conception of our science. But the idea of Salam and people like Lundquist, especially Salam himself, was actually to create an environment for the interaction between scientists from all over the world. Salam himself was a very good example of that. If you look at the scientific papers, you will see that most of them, in fact, a large portion of them are collaborative papers. And he deeply, deeply believed in that. And ICTP was created precisely with that point in mind. Several years later, in the course of preparation of a talk, I came across what's called a node map. A node map, which shows you see in this picture, you see United States, Canada, Japan, and some European countries. the density of lines around each node gives an idea of the scientific collaboration between that country and other countries in this picture. And this is from 96 to 2000. This has been prepared by British Royal Society, who repeated the same study between 2004 and 2008. And if you compare the two, you will see that there is sort of noticeable change in the density of lines around various countries. In fact, a little concentration on it will show that many of the countries in Europe have become denser in terms of these lines. Of course, one reason is that the progress in the technology, which enables the scientists to interact in a much more extensive way. One can ask, of course, the question, how much ICTP has contributed to the interconnectedness? This was partially answered in the previous presentation by the director of ICTP. As far as I know, there is no quantitative study of this, or not even a qualitative study of the kind that I'm showing here. But taking into account of over 5,000 scientists who visit ICTP every year from all over the world, plus the manifold of ICTP programs, associates, three ICTP branches, conferences, schools, and many other programs, I think that it will be very sizable. It will be very important. In fact, it will be very important to maybe to have some thoughts about this and make it sort of more visible, that the outcome could be quite impressive, in my opinion. So the scientists coming to ICTP not only talk to each other, but they also end up in joint research projects. I know by experience, by direct observation, many scientists from developing countries have gone to scientific visits to advanced countries simply through getting in contact with people by their participation in various activities of ICTP. Diploma program, despite its relatively small size, has contributed to this process. I think actually it has contributed quite a lot. As mentioned by Professor Doublecar, this program somehow has a holistic feature, as George Thompson likes to call it. And not only people come and participate in the program, their students also later on are sent by their teachers, that means the previous diploma students, to participate in this program. In recent years, I am still teaching, by the way, in recent years, in fact, this is very noticeable. I notice it almost every year. But still, many years of flourishing is still ahead of this program, and I'm sure in the next 30 years celebration or its 50 years celebration, the program has expanded much more than what it has done so far. I must mention that a lot of people have contributed in the creation of this program. Because of the shortness of time, I couldn't go through the names. In fact, apart from Fahim, I did not mention any other name, but this should not be an indication of negligence. It's simply, there's no time because the number of people, essentially all the scientific staff, and in the early years, it was mostly the affair of course, the high energy condensed matter and mathematics section. Many people in this section, in these sections who are still around or who have retired, did make substantial contributions. Later on, new generation of ICTP staff, like Paolo, for example, who is running this activity, made enormous amount of contribution to the program. So I think my time is over. And all is left for me to say is thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Saif. I was looking at the chat and somebody wrote, Professor Saif, you are always great. You will always remain the best professor you ever taught me. So I think this is a good thank to.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Saif.
Thank you.
Okay, so maybe I should introduce myself. I am Paolo Creminelli, and some of you probably know me. I was the coordinator of a diploma until last year. So you're probably wondering what is an icebreaker activity, and now you're going to find out what it is. So it's a way to play a bit together and to feel that we are a bit closer. Of course, we would like people to visit and to be in good in each like us, but it's not possible. Hopefully it will happen in the future. So we're going to play a bit like a game. So if you can put the Mentimeter slide. Okay, so you have to follow me, all right? So you have to go to a website, which is called www.menti.com. Now it will come. You can use these on your phone or your laptop or your iPad, whatever you want, but please do not close the Zoom session. So this will be something that we play with while we are connected to Zoom. Okay, I don't see the slide of Mentimeter. We'll take it a bit, okay. Okay. Okay, so you see the slide. So you go to this website, www.menti.com. And the only thing that you will be asked is the code. Okay, so you put this code, which is written there. I can read it for you. It's 39941860. Yes, maybe somebody can share it also in the chat. Somebody is asking. Okay, maybe I read the code again, just in case. 39941860. Okay, so I wait for people to connect. So what we are going to ask you questions. Everything is anonymous, so don't be shy. And anyway, it will be funny, hopefully. Okay, so I wait for people to connect. No, it's okay. I can change the slide here. Okay. Okay. Let's wait a couple more minutes. So I just wanted to prepare the first question. You have a very limited amount of time. It's just to check if you are awake or at least that you know something basic about ICTP. So be prepared. Then there will be a bit more serious questions later on. Okay, I see that 50 people connected. A lot of hearts coming out of different colors.
Different colors.
Okay, let's wait 1 minute more. Numbers are going up. Yes, so I see that there are more or less 200 participants. So let's see if half of them can connect to Mentimeter. 85. Okay, still going up, a lot of hearts. Okay. Okay, I think.
You'll be 200.
Okay. At least we can start with the first ones. Anyway, you can also join later. So let's go with the first question. So you have 30 seconds to answer this question. Who is the present director of ICTP? Okay. Okay. Let's see if you pay some attention in the last half an hour. Okay, you're doing good. You're good. Very good. Very good. You're doing very well. There is... Okay, five people voted for George Clooney, but they were probably confused by the picture because Atish looks very similar. Seven, actually, more confused. One is left to the very beginning of ICTP, voting for Abdus Salam, or maybe saying that Abdus Salam will always be the director. And seven participants are left with Fernando Quevedo, that maybe is connected, so we say hi to the previous director, Professor Fernando Quevedo, who is now in Cambridge. Very good. Okay, so this was to warm up. So let's go to the second question. Okay, so this is a bit more difficult. So you have to, depending on the size of your screen, but you have to select where you are from, so that we see how distributed we are in the world.
That's nice.
Very nice. You can see the screen, so the dots are very nice.
Yeah.
Very nice. Wow, there is somebody in, I don't know, I'm not even sure what is the name of this island close to Australia. Very nice. Okay, we have a lot of friends in India, a lot of in Iran, a lot of people are here in Trieste, Africa is growing.
So Pakistan is
very nice. Very nice. Yeah, this Iran, Pakistan. Very nice. So the distribution, we still need somebody from, well, now we have almost all countries. We need some Chilean to join. Very good, very good. But I think this nice description of the distribution of the ICTP diploma program around the world. So of course, many people came back to their own countries. Some are in other countries, and we are spread all over the world. So Narayan saying, I cannot see Trinidad and Tobago, it's too small. Okay, yes, now it's true. This was, it's already an issue for Italy, so. Okay, so let's go to the next slide. In which year did you receive your ICTP diploma program? So you have to write 4 digits, okay? So the time when you received your graduation, so the second year, if you want, when you get the diploma. Very nice, so the bigger, okay, now 2015 is winning at the moment. Teacher, you are 2015? Ah, no, so you're not, 2020 is winning. Rodrigo Castillo saying, yeah, 2017 is growing, good, good. Very nice, very nice. I think we see that the younger generations are a bit more active with Mentimeter. Somebody graduated 0000.
1945.
Not yet, not yet. There is somebody that says not yet.
1945 appears.
Somebody 2022. So they were good. There are also somebody connected that will graduate next year. That's nice. So the new students are coming actually in a few days, in a couple of weeks. So they are arriving. Very nice, very nice. So I think almost everybody voted. I'm afraid the winner is maybe is this year, basically, which makes sense. Actually, this will be also the graduation. On Wednesday, we will have the official graduation of the 2021 program. So we will have the students here in Budinic. Very nice. Okay, let's go to the next. Okay. Somebody is very quick. So you have to vote. You have to guess the year of the picture. Let's see. This is a bit more difficult. Well, okay, most people are guessing. Yes. Yes, very good. This is the 1992, is the second year of the diploma. And I think Saif is behind the bar at the moment, but it's there. There is a Salam, a Lundqvist, and Fahim in the back. That's good. Good. It's 1992. Good job. So let's go to the next. There will be three of them to guess. So there will be another diploma year now. Be ready. Yes, we have seen this picture in the previous talk. Yes, there was a suggestion. You also saw the director before the first question. So let's go to the next slide. Okay, this is more recent. Now we have the colors. There are new professors. Am I around? I don't know. Yes, I am there, very young, with a lot of hair.
You were all young.
Yes, 2010. 2010, I see Fernando Quevedo was the director. Yes, good. I think it's too easy. By the way, let me say that on Wednesday, we'll have another section of questions with Mentimeter, so be prepared. More difficult questions will come. Spot Professor Criminelli, yes. Yes, I am on the far right. Good, let's go to the next one. I think, unfortunately, it will be very easy. Unfortunately, let's see, we can move to the next slide. Yes, so this is, you can guess which year we took this picture. I find it very, very moving, the face of this student in the first row. Unfortunately, last year, the diploma ceremony was really limited in number. So diploma students were here, so although, so everything went on, but it was a very sad, well, it was what it is. I mean, we know, we all know about COVID. So there is somebody which is very pessimistic about the future and thinks that in 2031, there will be still the pandemic will go on. We hope not. Okay, so this was easy. I think we have the last question for today. Let's move to the next one. Oh, no, there are two more. So this is, again, you have to type whatever comes to your mind when you think about ICTP. And again, we will see that the words which are more common will become bigger and bigger on the screen. Well, science stays there, it's pretty big. Let me see, Adu Salam, friends, love, okay, passion, good. Unity, that's very nice. Diploma, connected, okay, scientific hub, dream, family, diversity. That's very nice. This, we can use it as a screen for the future, it's very nice.
Yeah, it's really very nice.
It's very nice. It's very nice because it tells you really what people are thinking about. Scientific in the science in the world. Somebody still says 2009. Okay, because probably thinking about the diploma back then. Italy, that's nice.
Cappuccino.
Rome, UNESCO. Okay, very nice. Very nice. We should take. I hope we can save this picture. Can we save this picture in some way? We can. Yeah. Okay, it will be recorded so we can take it. Very nice. Dream. I like somebody, plasma, somebody, an academic heaven. Very nice. Happiness. A temple of learning. Cappuccino. There is cappuccino. So, capo in B. Rodrigo says capo in B. Ciao, Rodrigo. Very nice. Very nice. Thank you. It is. I mean, it's a joke. It's a game, but I think it's it contains some information. I mean, it's nice to see this community. Mini world. Okay, let's go for the last. I think the last slide. Yes, this is a real question. Is to check how many ICTP alumni are in contact with, and you know, one purpose of these activities to foster a community, to foster a connection also when you leave ICTP, and it's nice to see if you remain in contact. Okay, well. Okay, so somebody lost a bit of contacts, or maybe just a couple of close friends that remained connected. Some is super well connected, more than 15. Lucia says, organizing this event has driven me reconnect with so many alumni. So we should have a column just for Lucia, more than 100.
Yeah, more than 100, I think that's right.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for playing with us. I think it was nice. I think it was a way to connect and to see that there are people there, and we're going to do it again on Wednesday with new questions and something a bit more serious, maybe. Very good. So now we move to the talk by Imrana. So let me introduce briefly Imrana Ashraf. She's an associate professor at the Department of Physics at the University of Qaeda Yazam at Islamabad in Pakistan. And she's also an ICTP associate. She's a good friend of ICTP. She visits ICTP as a student, as an associate, as a tutor, as a trill fellow, as a lecturer for the winter activity in optics. She's a well-known physicist in optics, and she was one of the first women to win the ICO ICTP prize in optics in 2004. She was also one of the four recipients of the 2017 Spirit of Salam Abdul Salam Award. But now she's not here to talk about her great science, not today. She's here to talk about her experience in building a network in Pakistan. And so we think that it can be for us a role model. And so please, I welcome Imrana Ashraf. Thank you.
Thank you, Paolo. Thank you, Atish. Okay, so I think it's on. Okay. Okay, so today, my name is Imrana, as Paolo mentioned. I'm from Pakistan. I'm a senior science associate at ICTP. Today, I would like to share with you the foundation and goals and aims we want to achieve under this Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society. So the layout of my talk, like any other talk, is the motivation behind this foundation, our mission statement, which is never complete. We have many missions which we want to accomplish under this Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society. Brief introduction to the founding members, then the registered members of a Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society. We have identified a group of focal person from each field. The activities we have organized so far, and the community engagement and forthcoming activities. So motivation, like most of the participants or affiliates from that visit ICTP in one capacity or another are from developing world. So scientific community working in the developing world faces many challenges. It can be the isolation from the vibrant international community. It can be lack of funding in struggling economy, non-existent of teaching and research laboratories, outdated curriculum, which really need to be modified in many schools and colleges back home, access to the lack of access to the latest pedagogical tool for teaching and learning, fewer national or international collaboration. So the foundation of PIAS can be considered as an advanced path of active learning in optics group, which is a self-funded program established in January 2016 under the umbrella of ICTP and Department of Physics, Qaid-e-Azam University, Islamabad. It brings physical science to traditionally underprivileged girls high school, colleges, and university to provide an enriching science experience in a very friendly atmosphere. We have organized, under this group, we have organized many one-day outreach activities to support and encourage girls students to pursue careers in sciences. These activities were mostly done with school and colleges of Islamabad and its twin city, Rawalpindi. In 2019, we extended these activities to the neighboring province of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. So this is, for us, it was the stepping stone to move towards the Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society. So Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society would like to extend the scope of active learning in optics activities to all across Pakistan and eventually make it to a regional society in association with ICTP. This is a picture from one of the outreach activity back in 2019 when Professor George Thompson and Sandro was there. here visiting another activity at National Center for Physics. And you can see the smile these diffraction glasses are bringing on seventh and eighth grader of a government school and Professor George Thompson and Sandro, they are also enjoying these holographic and diffraction glasses provided by ICTP, SPI and OSA. Okay, so Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society aims to further the mission of Abdul Salam International Center of Physics and establish a vibrant STEM teaching and research community working in Pakistan. So we want to establish an ICTP alumni work that can organize social and scientific STEM activities to bridge the gap between young and experienced researchers. And we hope to avail a success in a mutual learning experience in Pakistan and at ICTP. We want to nurture research collaboration internationally and among the National Institute of Pakistan. The society aims to facilitate the researchers by setting up collaborations with both national and international scientists at ICTP. This initiative will lead to the quality of research projects and research students produced within Pakistan. So our another aim is like in active learning and optics and photonics group, we also want to organize scientific outreach activities. And in line with Professor Abdul Salam's vision, we hope that the ICTP alumni will volunteer for this effort by offering their time and their skills. Through this forum, we plan to do teachers training workshops and possible revision of basic curriculum, which is the need of our. The society aims to provide career and vocational mentorship for research students, young and mid-career scientists for their professional career. So these are the brief introduction of founding members. I'm included. Professor Joseph Namela is our international scientific advisor from ICTP. Dr. Rahil Ali is from Qaid-e Azam University, Islamabad. Dr. Jahan Akbar, also an ICTP associate and winner of ICO ICTP award in 2016, is from Hazara University, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. Dr. Nigam Arshad is from University of Education, Lahore. Mr. Abdul Rahman is my PhD student. He was here as a trail fellow and left for home last month. So members affiliation with ICTP, so far we have 130 registered members, and some of them are senior associates, some postdoctoral fellows, ICO, ICTP award winners, trail fellow, associate diploma alumni and visitors. And if we divide it into gender, so there are 32 females registered member of Pakistan ICTP Alumni Society and 108 are male members. And their present affiliation is that 22 of these members are affiliated with private sector, 37 are affiliated with the public sector institute, and 71 are settled abroad. And on the Pakistan map, you can see that there are 3 from Balochistan, 4 from Sindh, and 60 from Punjab, which also include the capital territory, Islamabad. And as we all know that there are many visitors to ICTP from Islamabad and its twin city, it's Rawalpindi. There are 8 from KPK and 2 from Kashmir. So these are the focal list of a focal person we identified for the different fields. In laser and quantum optics, Dr. Javed Akram is from ComSets Institute in Islamabad. Dr. Rahil Ali is from Qaid-e Azam University, Islamabad. Dr. Jahan Akbar is from Hazara University in Mansera, which is Mansera is a city in Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. On condensed matter physics, we have Dr. Kashif Sabi from Qaid-e Azam University, Islamabad. Dr. Kalsoom Rahim, she is from University of Engineering and Technology, Texla. In plasma physics, we have Dr. Waqas Masood, who is also an ICTP associate. He works in ComSets. And Dr. Shahid Ali is presently based in National Center for Physics. In biomedical and biochemistry, basically Dr. Samina Khalid is based in Mirpur, is teaching in Mirpur University, and Dr. Saima Kulsoom is in International Islamic University, Islamabad. In material science and mathematics, we have Dr. Rafaqat Hussain, who is based in Balochistan. Dr. Shafkat Ali is working at Ghulam Isaak Khan Institute. In high energy physics, we have Dr. Jameel Aslam, who is also from Qaid-e-Azam University, Islamabad. Dr. Adnan Bashir is an old alumni of Qaid-e-Azam University and a student of Parvez Hoodbhai, and he is based in Mexico. Dr. Muntazir Abdi is also a diploma alumni, and presently he is a postdoc fellow in Switzerland. In environmental science, we have Dr. Adnan Abid, who is a former diploma alumni, as well as now he's doing a postdoc at ICTP with Professor Fred. Dr. Motasim Ishfaq is he's based in USA, and he's also from environmental sciences. In quantum information and quantum computation, we have Dr. Aisha Khalik. She is from National University of Science and Technology, Islamabad. Dr. Nigam Arshad is from University of Education, Lahore. And Dr. Muhammad Faryad is also an ICTP award winner. And he is from Lahore University of Management Sciences. So these are the focal person that agree to support different activities and organize these short courses in their respective fields. And we have decided to do these courses bilingually so that every student can understand it in a better way. If it will be in Urdu mixed with English, so it will be more understandable for many students. So the activities we have organized so far is, the first is the inaugural session that we formally inaugurated on January 26, 2021. Our chief guest for this virtual ceremony, but the chief guest was His Excellency Andres Ferrares, Ambassador of Italy to Pakistan. He welcomed the initiative and assured the participants that Italian embassy will help and support the society to achieve its aim. Professor Atish Dholkar, ICTP director, in a special video message, congratulated founding members on setting up PIAS within a short time and acknowledged the need of such platforms to bring together scientists and researchers. Professor Joseph Namela appreciated effort of joining hands to help each other at the scientific community in Pakistan. He shared his association with Pakistan, the outreach activities he has been part of over the years, extended his support for the society. So these are the images of photos of His Excellency, Professor Atish Dholkar and Joseph Namela. So these are the few visuals that I will try to pass quickly. And Professor Joseph Namela spoke about the different scientific programs at ICTP. And he shared his view about the society and So after 3 days of inauguration, it was the 29th of January, and it is Salam's birthday. So PIAS has celebrated Professor Salam on the 95th birthday. So Professor Fiazuddin was his PhD student. He sent in a special message to be read out by the participant of the session. He highlighted Salam's concern for promoting physics and his significant contribution to develop the scientific and technology vehicles infrastructure in Pakistan. Our keynote speaker was Professor Hoodbhai, who talked about Salam's journey from an outstanding student of rural Punjab, his exceptional research at Cambridge as a graduate student, to finally winning the Nobel Prize in Physics. He shared Salam's deep love and commitment to Pakistan and its scientific community. So these are the photographs of Professor Fiazuddin. He's in Canada, and Professor Hoodbhai, I think ICTP is familiar with him. And these are during the visuals of Parvez talking about Salam. And then the first outreach activity, the previous outreach activity we were doing from the Forum of Active Learning in Optics group. So this first outreach activity of 2021 was organized at Islamabad Model College for Girls, a public sector college situated near Qaid-e-Azam University. This college, among many other government school colleges that remained closed during 2020. So basically, those schools, colleges, and universities have lost 1 year of education or 1 year of knowledge. A full day of learning cannot compensate the loss of 1 year of knowledge, but a full day of fun with optics can bring joy for learning. So we were really happy to see those girls interacting with us, and they were very curious, but of course they were concerned about their loss of 1 year of education. So you can see this outreach activity was during COVID, and we were following the SOPs of this COVID pandemic. On the 11th of February, we celebrated the International Day of Women and Girls in Science. So around 100 undergraduate female students from Pakistan and abroad attended this session. The aim of the session was to create awareness among female students about careers in STEM. Students were encouraged to ask questions, share their opinions related to their respective academic careers. So these are the visuals of that meeting. So we have Dr. Negam, Dr. Shamuna Kazi, Maria is there presently in UAE, our ex-student, which are now teachers in different women universities and colleges. So this is, again, my outreach. Then we are honored to had two present and previous director of ICTP as our scientific speakers. So Professor Atish Tibolkar spoke about quantum black holes, where Hawking meets Ramanujan. And Professor Fernando Quevedo, the previous director, spoke about string theory and the real world. So these are the visuals of Professor Atish. And these are the visuals from Fernando's talk. Then in March, we maybe you saw my inclination towards female education. So we organized a special session to emphasize the importance of girls' education. The session was unique in a way that we have invited a famous celebrity, Iron Harun Rashid, as the guest speaker. He's an international pop star, and he produces Pakistan's first full-length 3D animated series under the name of Burka Adventure. So apart from girls' education, it considered many other social issues. So this session was broadcasted live on our social media channels. The participants, including students from primary classes, asked questions and took part in discussion. This Burka Avenger has been translated in many languages, and even it was allowed to show in Afghanistan, which I doubt no more. So this is Iron Harun Rashid, and many participants were from Maria Yuzel is past SPI president. Professor Jean Paul is the scientific director of UNESCO. Miss Hanan Davidar was also present during this session. So it was a big success for female education. The other distinguished speaker we have invited so far are Wanderley Salvador Beniato, a very good friend and a very good scientist from University of Sao Paulo, Brazil. He spoke about Bose-Einstein condensation and the investigation of computer turbulence. Mohammed Faryad is from Lahore University of Management Sciences. He spoke about quantum computers, principles, and its application. Professor Fred Kaczorowski is based at ICTP. He spoke about David and Goliath, tropical Atlantic influence on South Asian monsoon and Indo-Pacific oceans. So I think there you will find some. This is Wanderley Salvador Beniato, a familiar face for ICTP optics community. And this is Faryad. He's the winner of ICTP award. This is Professor Fred discussing his field of specialization with the participants. Again, Professor Fred. The other distinguished speakers are Mohtasim Ishfaq. He's based in USA. He works at Oak Ridge National Laboratory, USA, climate change in South Asia, well-known but not well understood. Professor Joseph Namela is a senior scientist at ICTP. He spoke about heating up turbulence near absolute zero. Babar A. Qureshi is from Institute of Business Administration, Karachi, Pakistan. He spoke about quantum structure of space-time and symmetry. This talk we held before Atish's talk in high energy physics so that people can, student can follow the basic first and then the advanced topics. Sandro Scandalo discussed the matter at extreme conditions from planetary interiors to new materials. Okay, these are the visuals, Joseph Namela, climate change in South Asia, the Mottesim stock. Then it is for Sandro stock. You can see Sandro on the right top corner. And this is Dr. Babar, who is in the Institute of Business Administration in Karachi. And then we have this community engagement. All activities are advertised via PIAS focal persons, email, and our social medias. I also share all advertisement with our associate page at ICTP social media, and also with the public information office at ICTP. All sessions are streamed live via Facebook. So far, we have almost 1,400 people that follow or like PIAS via the official Facebook. So then these are some international newsletter. Most of them are about our activities under active learning in optics. This was an article. The first is an article researcher teacher mentor by in ICTP newsletter in 2017. Then there is a letter in APS newsletter. It was the bringing the joy of scientific inquiry to girls in Pakistan. The third in July 2019 is there is an always light around the corner in ICO newsletter, which is International Commission of Optics newsletter. And then a recent article from ICTP is the new ICTP alumni network in March 2021. And recently in April, we have another article in ICO newsletter that is the Let the Light Be Always On. It was the, it mentioned the activities we did during pandemic. Okay, so this is Professor Nemela's very famous research article he wrote for the Nature Communication. It's Physics for a Better World. And I would like to share this photo. It was taken by Professor Joe when he was visiting 2016 in Pakistan. And these are our undergraduate students. And when somebody asked me, why girls? And look at this image, and it's so beautiful. Why not girls? So, and these are our founding members. And thank you. I think I'm on time.
So, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for your contagious enthusiasm, Imrana. Thank you. So you're perfectly on time. So now we're going to take a coffee break. Unfortunately, we are not able to send you a capo in B to your office. So you have to brew your coffee yourself. But let me remind you that during the coffee breaks, and as well as before, half an hour before the day of the conference and half an hour after the end of the main session, there is this platform called Wonder Me. You can just click, there is a link on the program, and you will find yourself with your avatar, and you'll be able to chat with your friends. So it's very easy to use, and it should replace the typical coffee break mood in which you go around and you say hi to all the new friends. Okay, so you find the link on the program. Okay, and otherwise we reconvene at 3:30. And we'll have the talks by Professor Jean Gates and Professor Shubhana Narasimhan about diversity and barriers in science and about gender discrimination. So I see you at 3:30, and we meet also in WonderMe during the coffee break. Thank you.